14. Don't run objects. Except for the condition of love, you owe each other. When you love others, you complete what the law has been after all along. The law code says, don't talk someone's life. Don't take what isn't yours. Don't worry.
All to the church in Rome, long, long time ago, St. Paul is one of the most important thinkers in the early Christian faith. And what he's saying is like, look, God is huge. We couldn't even approach God if we wanted to. We can't even understand God. But somehow God helps us understand him. And we were trying to figure out, okay, so how now do we live in response to what God has done for us and giving us life and giving us Jesus and giving us the Holy Spirit and all this? So what Paul is saying, this is, by the way, toward the end of his giant letter. His letter is like Mount Everest for like Christian thinking, okay? And what he's saying is that all the laws, all the ways that people are trying to figure out how to approach God and please God can be summed up with love, okay? So all throughout the years, hundreds of thousands of years, people are trying to figure out, how can I impress God? And Paul is saying, you can't. But the thing you need to do is to love. Okay? That all of this can be summed up in love. Okay? Now love is not like this mushy thing. It can be. But it's really about, do you show up for other people? Are you kind to your classmates and your teachers? Okay? Do you know that life consists of more than your own desires? Do you know that life is more than what you want? I think that's kind of what love is to recognize that you're the goal of life, okay? So that's how we can respond to God, is by loving others. And it's super simple, okay? You can do it right now by respecting your teacher, respecting your friends, being kind to people on the playground, all that sorts of things, okay? By letting someone in traffic. Would it kill you to let somebody in? And something so simple and sort of quotidian like that is just showing love. And that's letting God in. Okay? It's not that hard. We don't have to make it complicated. Alright, so now what we're going to do, cute, is we're going to sing about this.
Yes, we are. But we're going to have a little mini music class. You're going to see what it's like a little bit in our class, parents. You guys know what that's about, and you guys know what it's about. When I was reading through our scripture, what the word's going to be today, I am always thinking, okay, what song do we sing? What do we have that would really line up with what we're talking about today? And the same thing that kept coming back to me was one that I haven't even taught you yet. But we're going to do that right now, and you guys are going to get in on that too. So even in the back, I expect you to be up here. We're going to do something I do in class called an echo. An echo means I'm going to sing it first, I'm going to point to myself, then you're going to sing it right back to me. Now, the way that I explain to our children is try to make it sound as much coming back to me as it sounded when I put it out to you. An echo would not go hamburger, and what you hear back is hot dog. We're not going to do it in rounds today. You're welcome. We're just going to sing it. So, I'm going to go first. I'll point to you when it's your turn. Are you ready for this? I have